Hello and welcome to another lesson in Oracle Applications. In this series, we are studying purchasing. Today, I want to show you how to enter a manual purchase order. In our last lesson, we saw how to auto-create a PO. Now, we're going to manually create a PO. From your purchasing responsibility, go to your purchase orders submenu and go down to your purchase orders form and open the form. Some default information will appear, such as the date, the type, and the buyer that you're associated with in your user account. Some you will have to select. In this case, we'll select the operating unit. The PO is an auto sequence number in this case, not a manual one, so we're going to see that as a grayed out field. And that will appear once we save our purchase order record. So let's put in a supplier. In this case, there's only one supplier site associated with this supplier. Therefore, the site will default in. The ship to is defaulted in, and the bill to is defaulted in based on my user information. I can use a description field to type in information about this PO, and I can come down to my item field now, and I can select items if I'm purchasing inventory items or if I'm purchasing expense items. I can change this type if I wish, if I needed to purchase something for an expense, or if I needed to purchase freight or anything like that, I can do so. Most of the cases, I'm going to either be purchasing goods as expense items or inventory items. In this case, let's purchase some inventory items. If I put in some information to reduce my list, I can get a shortened list and pick that particular item. In this case, I'll leave the revision blank. We'll just choose the latest revision that's available. It will default in the category, description, unit of measure, and then I can put in the quantity and price. Sometimes the price is defaulted in. Sometimes it isn't. Depending on the setup of the particular item, that may or may not happen. Let's call that $100. Now I can put in a promise date or a need by date. However, I typically leave the promise date blank and choose to get that from my supplier because that is the agreed upon date that they can deliver. However, I can use the need by date to set a date that I need the item. And then the supplier can determine whether they can make that delivery date or not. If there's a supplier part number that I need to add, I can do so here. If this was being referenced to the item attributes, such as list price or market price, those would have defaulted in here. If I have any reference documents, if this were being sourced from, say, a contract or a blanket agreement or something like that, actually, if it was a contract, it would be select it here. I can put in a note to the supplier. I could put in a UN number. I could put in a hazard class if I need to do so. In this case, this is not being leveraged against a blanket order agreement, therefore my agreement tab is grayed out. Once I've entered this information, I can come down to my shipments field, and I can select the organization that I wish to ship it to. In this case, I'll ship it to Boston. And and I'll select an address here. That didn't show up the way I wanted it to. Let's see if I can find a Boston address. Sometimes these things aren't set up in a test instance. Ah, in this case they are. Okay, so there's my shipments information. I could put a note to receiver, or I could select a country of origin if I needed to do so. I could select my matching level that I want to invoice match against. And I also have a status tab. In our status tab, we can see quantity ordered, received, canceled, and billed. In this case, we haven't even approved the PO yet, so that's not relevant information just yet. I can set and change my receiving controls, change the delivery to inspection required if I wished. I can check my distributions and come over to the PO charge account. In this case, it's going to default in based on the item setup information. So it's done so here. Have a more tab if I needed to look at that information, or project tab if I needed to set up any project information. In this case, we're buying an inventory item, so it's not being designated to a project. After all that information has been input, I can add more lines if I wish to. It's going to ask me if I want to save my changes, so I'm going to go ahead and save. Alright, at this point, because I've saved, it's given me a PO number. I could come down here and I could choose to add some more lines if I wish. I could even come to my catalog and do a search for any previous purchase orders from that supplier. So if I were to do a find here, and this takes a second to run. Alright, even though it says it didn't find any records, I know that I can come back here and look for any prior purchases or sourcing rules that may be associated with this supplier as well. And there were some prior purchases. And let's see if there's any sourcing rules. Okay, no sourcing rules, but because there were prior purchases, I could, if I wanted to, well, I guess I can't. It's not letting me. Normally, you would see this add button set up so that you could add lines here to your order pad, and then you could hit select. Well, at least the select worked. And it brought in that information from the catalog. So now I've got these items, and I can come down and I can add my need by date. Alright, so now I've done everything that I need to do to create this PO. So I'm ready to go ahead and save that information. Oh, there's no shipments information. That's a good thing to know, because you need to set that. So let's set that. Let's see what choices we have here. And we'll select those. Now we'll save it. Alright, now at this point, everything's been filled out. We can approve our PO. And if I have enough approval authority, the PO will go to an approved state. And apparently I do, because it has gone to an approved state. So at this point, I could receive against this PO. But we'll learn that in a future lesson. Thank you for watching.